All right, so everything's been glued up, and now we just need to straighten things out a bit. So I already noticed a little bit of a whoopsie with the body. It is about on one side, it's literally just like a centimeter, so maybe 10 mil off. A little bit too narrow, but no bother. We'll just put a block there and fix that issue right up. So now, what? Girls, you know the drill.
So, we are looking at 37 mil for the neck and 44 for the body. Let's go straight to 43. Sounds a bit.
So the body itself, that's fairly straightforward because I already have a center line to follow, which is literally the joint. So I can just do that for the outline of the body. Now I can actually cut out that remainder from about here. Glue it onto that part right there. Now, the neck on the other hand, that's going to be a different matter. Because first I need to find the center line. And of course it's not an accurate number. So 62. Right there. Bear in mind, if you're doing this at home, something similar, at least, have a sharp pencil, not a pen, like me. Oh yeah, and seeing this, it's that way around, because we're making it. It is going to be a reverse headstock. Because, you know, I can do that. So that's my knot line. Right there. Which gives me the point at which I need to have it angling back. Now usually you only need to do a couple of degrees. I'm gonna go with 3 in this case. Then it's going to be about 13 mil thick headstock, so I'm going to draw that at 15 to give me a line to cut to. Yep. And I can figure out the rest of the measurements from there. And the rest. Not quite sure why I'm drawing that on right now, but yeah. That will definitely work. All right. Let's go bandsaw stuff out. First things first, let's cut out. Now, I want to get the headstock veneers plain flat, but seeing as they're kind of small, they're not going to go through the thickness here. But that's nothing that a little super glue and masking tape can't fix. Thank you. There we are. Much more secure. And together that gives me 33 mil onto the thickness surface. So, what did that say? 33, 32?
It's already at 32. 34. All right, so let's do 32 and hope that this goes well. Yep. Nope. Needs a little bit of help, but get the job done. Until I get it to about, 4 mil? That'll be a good amount, I think. Alright. And there we have it.
One headstock veneer. I should do the same for the back plate as well. Okay, so let's trim this headstock down to size. First things first, we'll move this up just a hair to give me a bit more control. Alright, gonna cut off all that excess stuff first. Just to make this that little bit easier for routing, I want to take off as much of the excess as possible. I screwed up. What I should have done? I should have drawn on the size of the neck first, which now I need to do. Yeah, damn it. I'm gonna go get the caliper real quick. Damn. I want to have this be rough size of 20 mil at the knot line. My caliper is running out of batteries. That's the bad thing about digital calipers. Fortunately, I don't need it to be digital. And then around the 12th fret, I want to do 23. It's about there. And yeah, there's going to be a volute. There-ish. Yep, volute about there. And taper that off to
about there. I'm still gonna, you know, get it a bit more roughly down the size. So now we can continue along and cut a little bit of a better cut. Move the camera over so you see what I'm doing. Alrighty, here we go. Let's try this again. Now, haha, I don't have much of a leg to stand on. Leave that flat because I want that to be a good gluing surface. Now, headstock shape. This headstock shape is basically going to be refined on a bobbin sander. So, chuck away the rest. Oop, missed. Cut the fretboard a little bit more down to size. Moving on to the next phase, which is templates.